Welcome, my lovelies. Welcome to my channel. Here we are doing the monthly reading for all zodiac signs. This is going to be for Taurus, my lovely Taurus. Sun, moon, and rising, of course. And this is how we're going to be kickstarting off the new year. I want to wish you guys very, very blessed 2018. I hope you guys spent these holidays surrounded by loved ones and people that genuinely do matter to you. And again, like I said, intention is everything. So put your intentions out there for this new year. Fresh new start, a new cycle, new beginning. Alrighty. Let's see, spirit alert. Messages for Taurus. Doesn't it feel weird, you guys, to be saying 2018? This happens to me every single year. The first month is always like, you know, 2018, wait, is it 2018 already? Probably just happens to me. But anyways, let's get into your reading, Taurus. Let's see what Spirit has for all of you guys for January 2018. Okay, one more shuffle. Spirit, what are the messages for Taurus for the month of January 2018? Okay, let's get into your reading, Taurus. All right, first card, Knight of Cups, Page of Swords, Ace of Pentacles, Two of Wands, Nine of Cups, wow, Queen of Swords, Six of Wands, Eight of Pentacles, the Emperor, the Eight, wow, okay. Well, my love, and then look at this. Wow. You guys have, out of all the readings I've done so far, you're the only sign that has three new beginnings, three new opportunities coming your way that are unexpected. So anyways, the Ace of Cups is emotional fulfillment, but it can also represent having stability in your emotional sector. The Ace of Cups is always a new beginning. Aces are always new beginnings. Obviously, we are in January, which is the beginning month of the year, 2018. So let's get into your reading, Taurus. Let's see what I can pick up. All right. So for a lot of you guys, the Ace of Cups, again, like I said, is the representation of being able to give and receive. Feeling like you're able to feel emotional fulfillment for some of you guys. You guys already know this in every single love reading that I've had. I always prefer to have the Ace of Pentacles because it is a promise for stability. But next to the Ace of Pentacles, the Ace of Cups in the same reading, definitely manifestations coming about for you guys. Now, again, for some of you guys can be dealing with a water sign. For some of you guys, water sign would be Scorpio, Pisces, Cancer. Doesn't have to be their sun. Could be their moon or rising or the attributes of that. This is a very, this is a partner that is very understanding, a partner that is very compassionate, very loving. And I feel that for a lot of you, Taurus, it's almost like you've kind of felt in the past that you haven't had that or you haven't been able to find that type of partner. Nonetheless, there is definitely a new energy coming towards you with the Knight of Cups. This is a love offering. For some of you guys, it could be actually an offering of a work opportunity. For those of you guys that have been unemployed or haven't been working for quite a while, this is, again, like I said, an opportunity to make more money, an opportunity of employment. For others of you, it is, in fact, someone actually offering you love or a love interest. Now, you are with the Knight of Cups is looking towards the Page of Swords. So for some of you guys may be dealing with, you're feeling almost like, for those of you guys that have been in a long-term committed relationship, you're feeling like either your partner's being very forceful or it's you the one that's been very forceful in this relationship, expecting them to either do too much or expecting or relying too much on them. It is a general reading, so it could be vice versa. It could be that usually the partners that you attract or bring into your life are usually fixer-uppers, and there's absolutely nothing wrong with that. We're not perfect, but try the best you can, Taurus, for this 2018, not to waste your time or effort in a relationship or in a person that is not wanting to put the effort to fix themselves, okay? We can't be Mother Teresa. We can't be, you know, a nurse or, you know, a doctor trying to fix someone that doesn't want to be fixed, okay? So just keep that in mind. For some of you guys, you may be dealing with a person that is already in your surroundings. This could be something that started off as a friendship and eventually turns into a long-term committed relationship. The Two of Wands is here next to the Ace of Pentacles. So partnerships, again, like I said, are very important for Taurus. Nonetheless, 2018, January, I feel that for the second week, you guys are going to have a heart-to-heart conversation in regards to what you're wanting and what you're wanting to bring about in this relationship. For those of you guys that have been in a long-term committed relationship, it could be that you guys are thinking of moving out or moving in together. And it's you guys sitting down and having a heart-to-heart conversation about what you're wanting to manifest in the future. Again, like I said, the Ace of Pentacles next to the Two of Wands, partnership is definitely being able to stabilize. For some of you guys that have been in a, you know, have been with your partner for quite a while, and this person has been helping you out or, you know, guiding you through financial difficulties, there's definitely a burden that's going to be lifted because, again, like I said, I do see offerings of work and finances coming in for you. And it's almost like you're starting to be more assertive, Taurus. You're feeling more confident, more believing in yourself is what I'm hearing. So it could be, you know, in two different spectrums. Now, I do want to mention, for some of you guys that are currently in a long-term committed relationship and this relationship just is not working, there's no communication, know and understand that you cannot allow new beginnings to come in if you're still holding on to the past or if you're still holding on to a situation that is not going to be altered. It's not going to change. You have to release yourself and stop looking to the past, okay? This is something we've been talking about for quite a while for you, Taurus. So it's time for you to understand and know that that person or people have played an important role in your life. Nonetheless, they're no longer in your life. You have to learn from that and move on. And also, do not make the mistake of comparing people, okay? Everyone is completely different. Everyone is their own person. Don't be afraid to love more than anything and give yourself an opportunity to actually be genuinely happy. You do have the Nine of Cups here, and the Nine of Cups is wish fulfillment. You have all the qualities, my dear Taurus, to actually start this new year in a very positive, positive way. Love is in the air for a lot of you guys, and fulfillment in regards to finances. I do see some of you guys purchasing a home or making an investment, purchasing a car or a home. To me is an investment, but it could actually be an actual investment, partnering up with someone else to start or to finance some type of partnership or business in the business front. Now, you do have the Queen of Swords here, and the Queen of Swords could represent an air sign. It could be a Gemini, Libra, and Aquarius. Doesn't have to be their sun, could be their moon or rising, or just the qualities of the Queen of Swords. And the Queen of Swords is looking towards the wish fulfillment card. So this could be you, Taurus, being in your head about a partnership or a relationship or a person that perhaps you already know. This could be a friend even that you're starting to have high hopes, you know, in regards to maybe we're meant to be, maybe there's a deeper connection. Try the best you can not to self-sabotage yourself and overthink things, okay? You have to allow things to happen organically. That's the only way, the natural way, I should say, to allow things to evolve in a positive way. Now, you do have partnerships, and the Six of Wands here is feeling victorious, feeling triumphant. You're triumphing over difficulties, being able to look towards the past in a very retrospective way, not attaching yourself to the past, but being able to really put initiation into your intentions of what you're wanting to bring for 2018. The Emperor here is looking towards the Eight of Pentacles. So for a lot of you guys, I feel that finally in the second to third week of January, there is an offer coming through, an opportunity that actually materializes where it has to do with work. So for some of you guys, it could be that you're offered a higher position. For others of you, you're offered a relocating type of energy, a relocating opportunity in the same company but in a different city, or you know, there is some travel involved. Nonetheless, it is going to benefit you ultimately because it is progressing and it is bumping your income. So that's definitely a good thing. Right at the bottom, you have the Ace of Wands. So again, we have a lot of new opportunities for Taurus, a lot of new beginnings for you guys. And January is the epitome of a new beginning. So try the best you can to see this in a positive way. Know and understand that whatever is no longer serving us, again, like I said, it's completely bananas to think. If you've been in a relationship and this relationship is over 10 years old and you're at a place where you're unhappy, because I feel that for some of you guys, this could be you, Taurus, the Queen of Swords, and it's almost like you're becoming very cold or very, what's the word? I wouldn't say cold, but very distant in regards to love and romance. For some of you guys, maybe you guys lost maybe you guys lost the positive attributes of remembering what it feels to be in love, or what to be, you know, how it feels when you're inspired by someone else. And that's always a beautiful feeling. And, you know, again, almost bitter, like somewhat bitter. And I feel that this for some of you guys, it could be this is your energy and you're looking towards wish fulfillment, like in a doubtful way, like, I am never going to be happy again, or I am never going to be able to move forward or succeed or grow, whatever the situation is. But again, like I said, it is very important that for January, I want to say the second week of January going into the third week, you start to see a lot of momentum in regards to finances and abundance coming to you, being able to get callbacks, being able to hear back from interviews even. And again, I definitely do see offers coming through for you guys. But if this is you, Taurus, the Queen of Swords, and you've become a little bit disconnected in regards to love and romance. Again, like I said, if you've been in a long-term committed relationship for over 10 years and you know without a doubt that there is no love there, responsibilities or children is what ties you or binds you to that person. Know and understand that we are the creators of our own happiness. And if you're stuck and you're unhappy, you have absolutely no one to blame but yourself. Why? Because you're allowing yourself to be in that situation. We are all here in this earthly plane to manifest and to grow. And if you're stuck and there's no growth in that, then it is not to the best of your interest. Sometimes we are attached, again, like I said, finances could be something very important, where we feel like if we separate or remove ourselves from that relationship, we're not going to be as well off as we've been, or we're not going to be as comfortable as we've been. Nonetheless, do you rather live a life attached to someone that is not making you happy for the remaining of your years? Or do you want to know again what it feels like, almost childlike type of energy, where you are, like, the possibilities are endless and you're excited and you are re-energized every single day you wake up? Again, like I said, try the best you can to ground yourself, meditate, ask Spirit Guide to guide you through this process if this is in fact you. And again, like I said, know and understand that there is a need of structure in your life in regards to love. So it could be structure in the sense of knowing and understanding that everyone deserves to be happy. Whatever happiness is for you, do what works for you and move forward with that. If it doesn't ring true to you and the person is no longer making you happy, don't be unfair to keep them in a loveless relationship and you be in a loveless relationship based off of responsibilities, because that's no way of living, okay? I hope you guys enjoyed this reading. Comment, like, and share. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, definitely subscribe. And we will see each other at the middle of the month. I wish you guys blessings. May blessings, joy, happiness, prosperity be bestowed upon each and every single one of you guys. And let's get into 2018 with the right foot. Put your intentions and put it out there. All right. Blessings. Bye.